enough to let me stay for 1 year.
Months of bloody territorial battles between pro and anti-government forces during the revolution turned cities into rubble, left thousands dead and many more wounded. The National Transitional Council, political wing of the armed opposition movement, was tasked with overseeing Libya's eventual move to democracy. It promised free treatment for those injured in the uprising. Instead, many still living in poverty were in desperate need of help.
The figure of about $2.2 billion has been spent on assistance programs for the wounded soldiers since the end of the conflict. We're still suffering the consequences of corruption and poor management, but we are finding solutions.
Libyan doctors back up claims that nepotism and backhanders remain the determining factor behind the particular medical care we've given. On Wednesday, Benjamin Gifford handed over power to the newly elected assembly. The nation's first chosen leaders are now facing the task of eliminating members of the old regime and providing support to those that desperately need it. With that, Sky News.
Final check on the standings, the watermelon has been good. say. Second place for Jamaica. That means silver, a place on the podium. And in third place, a weight in bronze. This is the medal tally. Well, that's the end of the day, but still plenty more action to come. Who's going to win the gold medal? We're going to be crowning the Olympic champions soon.